here to talk about composition and speed reading. Composition, according to us, it starts with the capacity to assemble words into sentences. Composition writing is now taught from the class of 3 in every schools, most probably in most of the schools in India. And we believe that this could be taught even in the primary, in the pre-primary also, in the kindergarten. Because in our school, we have the Glenn Dorman method of reading. So they are taught words from there. And at last, when the card is over, they are even taught sentences. So through sentences, we would like them to construct sentences and to modify the sentence structures. Now, there are commonly just 10 to 12 commonly used sentence structures in English. So when these sentences, if they are going to talk from an early age, so the kids can learn how to compose sentences. Now, for an example, that's a sentence, a simple sentence which says the girls are reading. Now, the boys are reading or the boys are playing is also a very simple sentence. And this can be made a compound sentence by introducing just the word and. And the same sentence, it can be modified to make it a complex sentence also. So by teaching a very simple sentence and then how to combine sentences and how to modify and vary the structures in a sentence, the kids can learn how to compose when they move on to the higher classes. And this sentence construction, we feel that it can be taught through playway methods. Now, most probably we would heard people trying out with jumbled words, asking the kids to frame sentences using that. Now we have a method that has been devised and it was proven by our founder. It was tested by him more than 40 years ago when he was a teacher in Cuddalore. It was a government school and it was a Tamil medium school, and he taught there to a particular student who was to appear for his final SSLC examination 40 years ago. Now this methodology, his methodology was to add words to a sentence. Now for example, you can see the first sentence, it says Jack eats. Just the simple sentence with just noun and a verb. It is a very simple sentence, and to this you can ask your kid to add words to it. Now, if a kid is going to come up with a word as carrot or beans or whatever it is, you can say Jack eats carrots. And one more word, if you are going to add to it, it is Jack eats fresh carrots. The kids, as they know the words through the Glenn Dorman method, they will be able to come up with new words which can be introduced in a simple sentence. And it can be expanded on and on. Jack eats fresh carrots at home. Jack eats fresh carrots at home daily. So this was a method devised by our founder, and we are in the formative stage of testing this method in our school at present. So we think that through Glenn Dorman they learn words, meaning, spelling as well as pronunciation. And through Spell Bee, I think it will be, Ms. Devakani will be telling more about Spell Bee, and through this method they are learning more about etymology, which enriches the vocabulary of a kid. So through teaching composition, we feel that they will be able to learn the sentence structures and how to vary the structures, and it will be helpful for them when they go on to the primary levels. So this can be taught even from the kindergarten levels. I would like to move on to my next topic about speed reading. It is a science which was developed in the West for professionals mainly, and it enables them to read fast. Professionals daily, they have, like executives, they need to read a lot. So when they have the ability to read fast, it gives them just a few minutes to read one of the files which they have to read daily. This can be gained by constant practice. When there is going to be constant practice for speed reading, it enables them to read faster, and it to double or triple, or even at times with constant practice, it enables them to read even up to 10 times faster than their normal speed of reading. It is really very much difficult. make an adult doing this, to follow a method, to have a habit of reading it daily. Because their habit is, the speed of reading is very much inbuilt and it is ingrained in them, and it needs deconditioning and it has to be retrained. So the adults have to be retrained to read faster. But then we think through, when the speed reading can be done with the very much young learners, it will become very natural for them, and to learn it very much like their first language, they'll be able to read faster. Now, usually when we read, we see one word at a time and we just read from the mind. We look at one word at a time. But then we think that the kids can have a wider and a wider area of vision. When they are going to read from the beginning, they can taught to learn, see a group of words when they read. And even later on, they can be taught to visualize the whole page of a book when they read. So when they are going to visualize a whole page of a book, this is going to enable them to read very much faster, and their comprehension also for kids, if it is going to be a natural habit for them, it will make them read very much faster also. Now the daily practice of 15 minutes for a kid at a school, it is really very much easy for a teacher to manage, and it can be done. And the average speed of every learner, it is maximum of 200 words per minute. So a 200 page book, it has a maximum of 50,000 words, and it would take 4.17 hours to read. And a speed reader with 500 words per minute can read it in just 1.67 hours. And if the speed reader is going to read with 800 words per minute, he'll take just 1 hour to read a 200 page book. Now this is Elon Musk, and he is the founder of SpaceX and Tesla. He was, as Mr. Ramesh Kumar, he mentioned that he is a self-taught entrepreneur. Likewise, he is also a self-taught entrepreneur. I don't say that he didn't get a degree. He got a degree in physics and economics. But then that didn't help him in finding his SpaceX and the Tesla, the companies of which he is a founder. He himself reads 2 books a day. He taught himself to aerospace engineering and automotive engineering just through books and self-taught. So we are at present in the initial stage of implementing these 2 methods of composition writing as well as speed reading, and we are very much open to suggestions from the educators from various schools. If there are any effective methods that they are practicing in their schools, and we welcome suggestions. Thank you.